And because the transhumanism is really the culmination or the apotheosis of the mechanistic worldview.
Yes, it's a culmination point, yes.
And that's really the story beginning to end that we are in the midst of now. Yeah. Do you think, just as we finish, do you think that, what's your general feeling having watched this episode over the last 2 years? How do you feel it's panning out now? Is it tapering off? Is it in abeyance? Is it waiting? What do you think is... have we further to go down this road?
No, yes, I think that, well, the corona narrative disappeared a little bit in the background, but society is even more vulnerable now for new mass formations. Just because the corona narrative and the corona mass formation led to the deterioration of the social bond even much more than it was already deteriorated before the corona crisis. It's very strange to see. Like now, students and personnel are allowed to come to university again everywhere, but they don't show up anymore. Only 5% shows up. And the rest stays home, saying that in one way or another, they lack the energy to leave their houses and to connect to other people again. So that shows exactly what I have been describing all the time, that a mass formation sucks all the energy away from the bonds between individuals and makes that they have no energy, that there's no energy left anymore to overcome the resistance that is always present in human relationships. So people prefer not to reach out to the other anymore and stay home. We've seen this at university, but also at the level of in all kinds of companies, people prefer to work from home, and they don't reach out to each other anymore. So the problem is definitely not solved. We went through one episode of mass formation, but we see that society is very vulnerable for a new one. Think about the entire societal reaction to the war in Ukraine, in which you saw a little bit the same characteristics. Suddenly, there was a new object of anxiety. There was this new intolerance for dissonant voices. There was this new lack of capability to talk, to open up, to listen to people with different opinions. We see the emergence of the narrative on the monkeypox now. Probably in a few months, the corona measures might return. Here in Belgium, our Minister of Health warns us now already that in a few months it will be necessary to vaccinate, to revaccinate the population, and so on and so on. I don't think it will finish here, and I definitely don't think that the tendency towards technocracy will stop here. In Europe, we'll probably be confronted with the introduction of the digital ID and also all the central banks are prepared to or at the verge of the introduction of digital coins. So the tendency towards technocracy will definitely not stop now. It will continue, I think. Nobody knows exactly how this will go, but we will see the evolution. We will see how, throughout the years to come, how the democratic system is replaced more and more by a technocratic system, I think. And yes. That's so important. The most crucial thing is that we should continue to speak out. I repeat this time and time again. All kinds of totalitarianism is based on mass formation. Mass formation is a kind of hypnosis, and the only thing that can disturb the hypnosis is the sound of dissonant voices. And so we should continue to speak out in a quiet way, sincere way, not thinking that we are the only ones who know the truth. No, just saying, like, look, to the best of my knowledge, this is what I think is going on, or I do not agree with the mainstream opinion. We have to continue to speak out because history shows us very clearly that it is exactly at the moment the dissonant voices stop to speak out that the cruelties start in a totalitarian system. Masses are always inclined to commit cruelties towards the people who do not go along with them, as if it is an ethical duty to do so. And they typically start to become so fanatically convinced. At the moment, the dissonant voices stop to speak out. And that's simply because at that moment, the hypnotic state becomes so deep, people become so fanatically convinced that the people who do not go along with them are completely irrational and lack every kind of solidarity and citizenship, that they think it is justified to start to commit cruelties towards them. That started to happen in 1930 in the Soviet Union, in 1935 in Nazi Germany, each time a few months after the resistance or the dissonant voice stopped to speak out in public space and went underground. So we shouldn't do that. We should continue to speak out as well as possible, as sincere as possible, not because we think we will convince the other people and wake them up. No, not at all. We won't be able to convince them. That usually doesn't work. But that doesn't mean that we have no effect, because every time you speak out, you disturb the hypnosis a little bit. That's something that was very well described by Gustave Le Bon in the 19th century.